गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक अगेन विद द नेक्स्ट सेशन ऑफ साइंस वन. लास्ट टाइम वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट हाई टाइड्स एंड लो टाइड्स, हाउ द ग्रेविटी प्लेज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल ऑन द हाई टाइड्स एंड लो टाइड्स. नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट अर्थ ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स, दैट इज जी, एंड हाउ इट इज एक्टिंग ऑन एन ऑब्जेक्ट व्हेन इट इज थ्रोन इन अ अपवर्ड डायरेक्शन. नाउ here in order to explain that I have drawn this diagram. Here imagine an object is at the bottom on the surface of the earth. Here the velocity is zero. As soon as we apply force and push the object in the vertically upward direction, the velocity is initially it is maximum, but as it goes above the surface of the earth, the force of gravity is acting. Now here at every time or each and every stage, you can see here the object, I have drawn arrow upward and downward. Now as it moves here, every time two forces are acting. Now one force is in the upward direction, one force is in the downward direction. Initially in the upward direction force is more and downward direction force is less, but as it goes up, the upward direction force is going on decreasing, downward is going on increasing, and a stage comes out where both upward and downward force both become zero. Here the velocity is zero, forces are acting equally on the object. Now as soon as the velocity becomes zero for a fraction of second, now this time the Earth's gravitational force is more than the force which is being applied, and as a result of which now the object is moving in the downward direction. Now the upward force is less, downward force will go on increasing. See here, upward force is less, downward force goes on increasing, and at last before it touches the ground, the downward force is maximum and the upward force is least. So here we have seen that every time on this object, the force of gravity is acting on the object. Now the force is acting on each and every object, that we are knowing it. In the Newton's experiment where apple has fallen down on his surface or on his earth or on his head, then he has raised one question, and the question was why the apple did not go up, why it fell down, or why only that earth is attracting the apple, why the apple is not attracting the earth. And at that time the reason was thought, and it was found out that the mass plays an important role in the force of attraction. Of course earth is attracting the earth, apple, and apple is also attracting the earth, but the mass of apple is very meager, very less as compared to the mass of the earth, and therefore though apple is attracting the earth toward itself, but because the mass is very less, and therefore the earth cannot jump and attract towards the earth. Now here there is also a question raised here that if the earth is attracting the moon and the planets, why the moon and the planets is not falling on the earth. The reason behind is that moon and other artificial satellite, they are revolving around the earth's orbit with a great speed. Now this speed is balancing the earth's force of gravity. If this speed would have, this velocity would have not been there, then at last what would happen, the artificial satellite, all this, they are revolving around the earth's orbit, but if the velocity is zero or not there, ultimately moon as well as artificial satellite, they will come towards the earth, which is directing towards the center of the earth. So that is why the moon and the other artificial satellite, they are not falling towards the earth, because they are set into certain velocity, and because of which they continuously rotate in the orbit. Now Next is Earth's gravitation acceleration, that is G. The Earth exerts gravitational force on object near it. According to Newton's second law, force acting on a body results in acceleration due to gravity G, which is a vector quantity, as it is directed towards center of the Earth vertically downward. What if there is no gravity? What will happen? Of course, our weight will be weightlessness. It will consider as we are floating on the surface if the gravity is zero. And what if the capital G, that is universal gravitational constant, is doubled? The force of attraction between the two objects will increase, will be doubled. Now, variation in the value of G. Or before that, we can calculate the value of G on the surface of the Earth by the formula F equals to gmm upon r square, where F is also equals to mg. You can see here m and small m is mass of the object, that is constant or same, that is cancelled, and at last we get the value of G, or formula of G, as capital gm upon r square. Capital G is gravitational constant, 6.67 into 10 raised to minus 11 newton meter square per kg square. Capital M is mass of the Earth, that is 6 into 10 raised to 24 kg. And this R is the distance between the center of the Earth to the surface of the Earth, which we take it as radius of the Earth, which is nothing but 6.4 into 10 raised to 6 meter. And since here square is there, we have to put here square. After calculating, we get the value of G as 9.77 meter per second square. Variation in the value of G. Now, various other factors play an important role in the variation of G. One of the first factors here, change along the surface of the Earth. You can see the shape of the Earth. It is not exactly spherical, somewhat oval shape, as a result of which the position of the object towards the center is different. From the pole it is different, and from the equator it is different. You can see here the distance from the pole to the center is less than the distance from the center to the equator, as a result of which here the force of gravity also changes. Acceleration due to gravity also changes. And therefore, the value of G at the pole is maximum, which is nothing but 9.83 meter per second square, whereas the value of G at the equator is 9.78 meter per second square. By mistake, 9 is not written. You have to do the corrections here. G equals to 9.78 meter per second square. And the reason behind this, already it is said, see here, small r is less than capital R. By seeing the diagram, you can understand this radius is small and this radius is big, as a result of which there is difference in the gravity. This is one of the reason for the variation in the value of G. The another reason for the variation in the value of G is the height above the surface of the Earth. In order to explain that, you can see here what diagram is drawn of the surface of the Earth. Now, on the surface of the Earth, height is zero. The value of G is 9.8 meter per second square. Then, at a height 8.8 kilometer, the value of G is 9.8 meter per second square. Here, 8.8 height lies here our Mount Everest. Similarly, man-made balloon has reached up to a height of 36.6 kilometer, where value of G is 9.77 meter per second square. And weather satellite, artificial weather satellite, has reached to a height of 400 kilometer, where value of G is 8.7 meter per second square. And a communication satellite has reached to a height of 35,700 kilometer, where value of G is 0.225. This table clearly indicates that as we move higher above the surface of the Earth, the value of G goes on decreasing. So here, one of the two reasons we have already known. Now, one more reason is there for the variation in the value of G. Now, as per the formula, it clearly indicates that as the value of R decreases, the value of G increases. But here, it does not matches with this here, with the change in the depth. As there is a change in the depth or decrease in the depth, as a result of which, what happens here? The gravity goes on decreasing. Instead of increasing, the gravity is decreasing. Why so? What is the reason behind it? In order to explain that, I have drawn one diagram here. You can see this is the actual shape of the, or approximate shape of the Earth. Now, at the surface of the Earth, the mass is M1. But as we go deep inside the Earth, the mass of the Earth is also changed. As a result of which, gravity is decreasing. Again, if we go deep inside the Earth crust, here again, the mass of the Earth will go on decreasing as we go deeper inside the Earth, and as a result of which the value of G also decreases. So as soon as you reach at the center of the Earth, where mass of the Earth will be considered as zero, and therefore value of G will also be zero. So in this case, it is not following the formula G, that is small g equals to capital Gm upon R square. Distinguish between mass and weight, which we already studied in 9th standard. Mass is defined as amount of matter in the object, whereas weight is defined as force with which the earth attracts the object. Mass is a scalar quantity because it is only dependent on magnitude. Weight is a vector quantity because it is depending on magnitude as well as direction. Mass is always constant, whereas weight is changing as per the value of G, because G is not same everywhere, it is changing at different places, and therefore weight will also differ. The unit of mass is kg, whereas unit of weight is Newton. Mass is independent of gravity, weight is dependent on gravity. Now, we are aware about the various types of waves. When we throw a stone in the water, the waves are generated on the water. As well as light is also having waves. Because of that light, we also call it as electromagnetic waves. X-rays and other rays which are being generated, these are nothing but one form of the electromagnetic waves. Same way, waves also being generated by the heavenly bodies above, very far away from the surface of the Earth. Now, we call this as gravitational waves. Gravitational waves are different types of waves on the fabric of space-time. These waves are weak and difficult to detect. But there is one device called as LIGO, which is useful in detecting the intensity of intensity of gravitational waves. This is just an additional information which is there in your textbook. That's all for today. Have a great day.